Did you know that the San Andreas Fault is capable of producing earthquakes that can exceed a magnitude of 8? That's powerful enough to cause widespread destruction across California. The San Andreas Fault is one of the most notorious fault lines in the world, stretching over 1,200 kilometers through California. It's a major transform fault, which means it's responsible for the horizontal movement of tectonic plates. This unique characteristic makes it a hotspot for seismic activity, and its geographical significance cannot be overstated. Running through the heart of California, the San Andreas Fault passes through some of the most densely populated cities in the United States, including Los Angeles and San Francisco. This proximity to major urban centers makes it a significant threat to human life and infrastructure. Dr. Emily Johnson, seismologist and professor of earth sciences at Stanford University, emphasizes the grave risks associated with the San Andreas Fault's proximity to urban centers.
The San Andreas Fault poses a significant and ever-present threat to cities like Los Angeles and San Francisco. Its location means that any major seismic event has the potential to cause catastrophic damage to densely populated areas, endangering countless lives and leading to vast economic losses. A major earthquake could result in the collapse of buildings, severe disruption of infrastructure, and a prolonged recovery period. The impact would be felt not only locally, but also nationally, given the economic importance of these cities. It is imperative that we continue to advance our understanding and preparedness to mitigate these risks. Investing in earthquake-resistant infrastructure, conducting regular drills, and raising community awareness are crucial steps in ensuring the safety and resilience of our urban centers. We must remember that while we cannot prevent earthquakes, we can certainly prepare for them and minimize their devastating effects.
The San Andreas Fault is not just a geological feature. It's a force of nature that has shaped the very landscape of California. Its slow but constant movement has created the dramatic mountain ranges and valleys that characterize the state's topography. In the history of the San Andreas Fault, there have been countless earthquakes, some small, some devastatingly large. One of the most notable events was the 1906 San Francisco earthquake, which killed over 3,000 people and left hundreds of thousands homeless. The quake itself was a 7.8 magnitude event that ruptured the fault for over 400 kilometers. The 1906 earthquake was a wake-up call for scientists who began to study the fault and its behavior in earnest. They soon discovered that the San Andreas Fault is part of a larger system of faults that crisscross California, all of which are interconnected and interdependent. The movement of the tectonic plates is driven by plate tectonics, a process that involves the gradual movement of these massive slabs of the Earth's crust. As the Pacific plate moves northwestward, it encounters the North American plate, which is being pushed beneath it. This process, known as subduction, is what drives the earthquakes along the San Andreas Fault. The San Andreas Fault is not just a California problem, it's a global issue. The same tectonic forces that shape the Earth's surface in California are at work across the planet, creating fault lines and earthquake zones that threaten human populations everywhere. In the 1950s and 1960s, a series of major earthquakes struck California, including the 1952 Kern County earthquake and the 1966 Parkfield earthquake. These events further underscored the need for scientists to understand the behavior of the San Andreas Fault and its potential for destruction. Today, scientists estimate that there is a 2% chance of a magnitude 8.0 or greater earthquake occurring on the San Andreas Fault within the next 30 years. That may seem like a small probability, but the potential consequences are too great to ignore. A major earthquake on the San Andreas Fault would be catastrophic for the cities of Los Angeles and San Francisco. The destruction would be widespread, with buildings collapsing, roads cracking, and entire communities losing access to basic services like water and electricity. The good news is that scientists and policymakers are working together to prepare for a potential disaster. Infrastructure improvements, such as earthquake-resistant buildings and retrofitted bridges, are being implemented across the state. Dr. Emily Roberts continues to discuss building codes and construction practices.
The advancements in building codes over the past few decades have significantly enhanced our ability to withstand seismic events. Modern construction practices now incorporate stringent standards to ensure structures can absorb and dissipate seismic energy, thereby reducing the likelihood of catastrophic collapse. However, despite these improvements, challenges remain. Many older buildings still lack the necessary retrofitting, and funding for widespread upgrades is limited. Additionally, urban infrastructure such as bridges and utility lines require continuous monitoring and reinforcement to mitigate the potential impacts of a major earthquake. Furthermore, while new buildings are being constructed with these advanced techniques, the process of upgrading existing structures is slow and arduous, often hampered by regulatory and financial constraints. Thus, while we have made considerable strides in earthquake preparedness, there is still much work to be done to ensure the safety and resilience of our communities in the face of future seismic events.
Community awareness initiatives are also crucial in preparing for a major earthquake. By educating people on what to do during an earthquake, we can save lives and reduce the risk of injury. In addition, researchers are working on early warning systems that can detect the seismic waves generated by an earthquake, giving people precious seconds or even minutes to seek safety. Dr. Jonathan Spencer, director of the Seismic Research Institute, explains,
"Early warning systems function by detecting the initial seismic waves, known as P waves, which travel faster than the more destructive S waves. These systems can alert people seconds to minutes before the shaking begins, allowing them to take protective actions. However, predicting earthquakes remains an elusive goal. The complexity of geological processes and the lack of consistent precursors make it extremely challenging to forecast the exact time, location, and magnitude of an earthquake. Despite significant advancements in technology, we still cannot predict earthquakes with accuracy, which is why preparedness and early warning systems are crucial in mitigating their impact."
As we've seen, the San Andreas Fault is a powerful force of nature that demands our respect and attention. By understanding its behavior and potential for destruction, we can take steps to prepare for the worst and minimize the impact of a major earthquake. To conclude, the San Andreas Fault is a deadly force that cannot be ignored. Its potential for destruction is clear, but by working together, we can reduce the risk of disaster and create a safer, more resilient California. Don't forget to share your thoughts on earthquake preparedness in the comments below. And if you want to learn more about natural disasters, be sure to check out my other videos.